Welcome to Integration Made Easy, a video series brought to you by Miracle's Integration Center of Excellence team.
Hi everyone, I am Danesh Ande. I am working for Integration Center of Excellence team. Now I am going to present a demo on building and running of IIB /MQ/DB2 on Docker. This is my agenda for the day. I will give you an introduction to Docker and the comparison between Docker containers and virtual machines, and also the advantages of running IBM Integration Bus, Websphere MQ and IBM DB2 on Docker with live demo. Docker introduction. Docker is an open platform for developing, shipping and running applications using container virtualization technology. Docker allows you to package an application with all of its dependencies into a standardized unit of software development. By using Docker, we can create and deploy our applications on server. Moving on to the next slide, Docker is a shipping container for code. Like developers can develop the code and build a Docker image, and we can run it on Docker containers, and also we can push it to the Docker Hub, so that we can ship it to anywhere and run anywhere. We just need to configure once and run anything. If you see this slide here, we can run it on development VM, QA server, customer data center, on public cloud, and also on production cluster, and finally on contributor's laptop. In this slide, we will see the comparison between the virtual machines and Docker. Firstly, I will explain you about virtual machines. Each virtual machine includes the application, the necessary binaries, and an entire guest operating system. All of may be tens of GBs in size, but coming to the containers include the application and all of its dependencies, but share the kernel with the other container. They run as an isolated process in the user space of the host operating system. They are not tied to any specific infrastructure. Docker containers run on any computer and on any infrastructure and cloud. The most advantages of running our application on containers is containers are less weight, and also it requires less CPU and less RAM, and containers are portable. The prerequisites needed to work with Docker are Docker Toolbox, Docker Registry, and Docker Hub. We will install the Docker Toolbox on our Windows system, and then we will push the base images of IIB, MQ, and DB2 from Docker Hub. Pulling IIB 10 images from Docker Hub. First, we will log into the Docker Hub and then execute the command Docker pull IIB on our Docker client, which is installed on our Windows operating system. And then we will run that image and deploy our applications in the runtime of IIB provided by the Docker. Create and start broker. After pulling the image from Docker Hub, we can work with IIB. But initially, we have to run that image file as shown below, and it will automatically set the path as shown in the screenshot below, and then we can work with MQSA commands. Deploying of bar file. Finally, we can deploy the bar file in the IIB runtime provided by the Docker and test our applications as shown in the screenshot below. MQ on Docker. We will also pull the base images of MQ from Docker Hub, and we will create Docker file with one queue manager and queue init on the top of base image, and we will build a new MQ image, and then we will run that image by mapping with some port number. Moving on to the next slide, DB2 on Docker. We will also pull the IBM DB2 from Docker Hub, and we will create a DB2 instance and also a sample database, and then we will connect to the database and do some work on it. Like I have developed the use case on it, which will be explained in the live demo. Use case of DB2 on Docker with IBM Integration Bus. Here the explanation about the use case is, my IIB flow gets a message from Websphere MQ, and then it will create a table in DB2 which is running on Docker. I will show this in my live demo. Advantages of running IIB, MQ, DB2 on Docker. It's scalable. We can easily spin up new containers whenever we need it, and containers are lightweight. Like containers running on a single machine all share the same operating system and kernel, so they start instantly and make more efficient use of RAM. Images are constructed from layered file systems, so they can share common files, making disk usage and image downloads much more efficient. Docker allows us to create a simple runtime environment once, package it up, then run it again on any other machine. In case of system crash or failure, then it is easy to pull our images from Docker Hub. Now we will move on to the live demo of running IIB on Docker. This is my Docker terminal. Now I will list our Docker images. See, here we are having different Docker images, like we are having IAB also. I'm copying this command for running IIB. This is my Docker terminal. Here I will execute the Docker commands for running IIB, MQ and DB2 in Docker. Firstly, I will run IIB. If you see here, it is setting the path and it is running on, and it is creating a node called ICE, and the container is running. Now if we open the browser and type the port number along with the IP address, 192.168.99.100, this is the Docker default IP address. Now we will type the IIB port number 4414. If you type enter, we can see the runtime of IIB provided by Docker. Here we can create the integration servers. I am creating one default server. And the default server is being created. Now I will we can deploy our IIB flows here. Deploy. We will browse for the bar files. We are deploying some bar file. We can see the content that is available in the bar file and click on deploy. The deployment of bar file is successful. Now we will go for MQ. The container of IIB is running. Now I want to stop this container. Now I will run the MQ container. Firstly, I want to go to the location of the MQ Docker file. Now I will build the MQ image. The MQ image is created with one queue manager. If we type Docker space images, we can see here MQ image, which is created 9 seconds ago. Now I want to execute this MQ. This is the command for executing MQ. Okay, the port number is allocated by some other container. The MQ container is executed. If you type Docker space ps, you can see here the MQ container is running. Now I will execute this container. Now we are inside the MQ container. We can create queue managers, anything we want. I want to list the queue managers that are available. If you see here, queue manager QM1 is running. Now I want to run the DB2 on Docker. This is the command for running DB2 on Docker. I'm pasting here. In this command, I am mapping my database with 5000 port number and giving DB2 password and username and accepting the license. Now I want to create a DB2 instance. The DB2 instance is created. Now I want to create the I want to start the DB2. Now I will create the sample database. The sample database is being created here. The sample database is created. Now we will connect to this database. If you see here that I am connected to the database which is running on Docker. You can see the database information here. Now I will use this database with my IIB. This is by IIB flow which is developed. Here I will get one MQ input message from MQ and it will pass through this IIB and create a table in Docker database which is running on Docker. I want to deploy this flow. If you see here the code, I have written the code for creating the table employee 258. If we open here and describe the table, we have 0 records selected. Now after executing this flow, we will check whether the table is created or not. Now I will put a sample message in this queue, input queue. My AV flow got triggered here. If we click on step over, it is processed successfully. Now we will check in my Docker database. We can see here 3 records selected. Before there are no records, now we are having 3 records. In this way we can use DB2 on Docker with our IIB flow.
Thank you for watching our video on Integration Made Easy, a video series brought to you by Miracles Integration Center of Excellence. For more information about this playlist and for more videos, please visit www.miraclesoft.com/IME.